the Revanna sex scandal continues to intensify as trouble continues for the father-son duo. A second FIR has now been registered against Prajwal Revanna, based on a complaint by a former Zilla Parishad member from Hassan. The victim says she was repeatedly sexually assaulted and filmed by Prajwal and was later blackmailed by him to not speak about it. This, remember, comes even as a second notice has been issued to HD Revanna and Prajwal Revanna to appear before the SIT. Amid all of this, Prajwal Revanna's father, HD Revanna, moved court seeking anticipatory bail of the hearing for which is scheduled today. Also, an FIR has been registered against HD Revanna after one of the victim's son complained that his mother has been kidnapped. She was one of the women seen in the alleged sex videos with Prajwal Revanna. Meanwhile, Prajwal continues to remain in Germany, even as his request for 7 days' time has been rejected. Karnataka Chief Minister Siddaramaiah has accused the central government now of protecting Prajwal Revanna.
ರಕ್ಷಣೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಪ್ರಜ್ವಲ್ ರೇವಣ್ಣನ ರಕ್ಷಣೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋರು ಕೇಂದ್ರ ಸರ್ಕಾರ.
All right, let me go across to my colleague Neha, who's been tracking this case for us. Neha, what's the latest in the probe that has been happening? An FIR, another FIR has been registered against Prajwal Revanna. And of course, he continues to be out of the country, even though his 7-day time period, which he had asked for to join the probe, has been rejected.
Well, that's right, Shreya. Of course, you know, it seems like trouble here mounting for Prajwal Revanna, as you know, the SIT that's investigating the case against him and his father, HD Revanna, has now issued a second notice to both of them. Remember, a lookout circular has already been issued against Prajwal Revanna over here, you know, of course, which essentially means that as soon as he touches the country, or as soon as, of course, you know, he tries entering India, he is, of course, likely to be detained. Now, if we're to talk about HD Revanna there, we saw that, you know, while, of course, he is reportedly still in Bengaluru. As of yesterday, we knew he was in Bengaluru. He's still not turned up for the SIT probe right now. Obviously, raising questions about what action the SIT would take against him next. Two notices have gone out already, and he's not adhered to both the notices. As far as the anticipatory bail application is concerned, he, of course, withdrew that from the court today. But we'll really have to wait and see what action comes through. The Karnataka Home Minister there not mincing his words, very clearly suggesting that if at all they do not appear, then the government would not stop short of their arrests. Now, of course, the concerning part over here, Shreya, is the fact that we just brought details of that second FIR there, where the woman there in concern says that not once, but multiple times, she says she was sexually assaulted, she was blackmailed, she was forced into those videos being recorded, and it's only seeming to get more ugly for the father-son duo here.
Right, Neha, the controversy also, of course, intensifying the political war of words this election season. The Chief Minister has now accused the centre of protecting Prajwal Revanna. But the Home Minister, we did hear him say that, you know, it was the responsibility of the state government to take action against him.
That's absolutely right, Shreya. You know, as unfortunate as it is, while the focus of this case, you know, by all the political parties here in concern should be on bringing the perpetrators to the book and ensuring justice here to the victims, it seems like an ugly war of words there has broken out. While the state government has, of course, been blaming the centre here, raising questions about why they are ally partners with a party like that and why he was allowed to flee the country, why his passport was not seized. On the other hand, now you have the centre as well that's come down hard on the state government, raising questions about how he was allowed to leave Karnataka in the first place. Of course, we must remember one thing, Shreya, that, you know, at the time that Prajwal Revanna has fled the country, what we do know is that reportedly neither was this FIR filed nor was this SIT formed. Now, if we are to, of course, talk about the charges over here, more so the grave charges against him, the fact is that this is a video that was out for quite some time now. HD Revanna, they're saying that it's been 4-5 years old, this entire video, whether it's fake, whether it's morphed to something that he's not really, you know, confirmed there. But at the end of the day, of course, you know, politicians are going to play politics, Shreya, and we should hope that those investigating this case are able to come to a logical conclusion at the earliest.